to the Lord. Call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the people. Sing to him. Sing songs to him. Talk yea of all his wondrous works. Welcome to the morning service. We are glad you are here. Please join us in opening the service by singing This Little Light of Mine of page 511.
I'm gonna let it shine.
singing and on devotions. Next song, everybody clap your hands.
Amen. You may be
Keep your voice.
about the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Because some of us learned at a young age, but some of us didn't.
Amen.
And we wish we had. Because when you know who you can call on,
amen,
when your time of need, that's all you really need.
Amen.
All you need is Jesus.
That's right.
For everything. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. We come to give him some praise.
Amen.
And lift up his name.
Amen.
And give him glory. Anybody? Give him glory. Not just for what he's already done, but for what he's doing for us in our future. It is God that is our future. He is the one leading and guiding us. All we have to do is be humble and listen, and he will teach us the way to go. Amen. All right, let's give the Lord some praise this morning. Yeah.
Yeah. going up yonder to be with my Lord.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. We're going to go into our change of service just a little. We're still going to worship him in spirit and in truth. Mm-hmm. But we're going to worship him through giving. Mm-hmm. He tells us to honor him with our substance, mm-hmm. to honor him with the first fruit of our increase.
Yeah. Amen.
He also tells us that if we would give sparingly, mm-hmm. we will reap sparingly.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
He also says that God loves a cheerful giver.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Let's just come forward. You can
be thanksgiving.
Thanking you for this day, and in Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Good morning.
Good morning.
Our scripture for the week is Mark 8:36 says, "For what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the whole world and lose his own soul?"
Sure.
Do we have any first-time visitors? If so, please stand. No visitors? We are all at home. We have no birthdays or anniversaries this week. So our announcements are, our Thanksgiving basket drives begin October 6th through November 20th. The list will be posted in back. Free health fair October 12th here at church, more information to come. Please remember to pray for those names that appear on our prayer list. Our weekly services are Sunday school 9:30 a.m., Wednesday prayer meeting and Bible study will resume October 16th with the book of Ephesians. Sunday worship 11 a.m. These have been your announcement for this week by youth announcement clerk Sister Peyton Triplett. Please govern yourselves accordingly.
Amen.
We want to thank Sister Peyton Tribble for those just made announcements. Now we ask that you prepare your hearts and your minds to receive the word. I have known the speaker for over 60 years, and I know that truly she is a woman of God. So as she come, let us lift our right hand in acknowledgement of her, Dr. Dottie Ford.
Dr. Dottie Ford.
Do me like Jesus, He
Said, the serpent deceived me, and I ate. Mm-hmm. Verse 14, the Lord God said to the serpent, because you've done this, cursed are you above all livestock, mm-hmm. and above all beasts of the field. Mm-hmm. On your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. Mm-hmm. And then on 15, verse 15, the Lord tells Satan, I will put enmity between you and the woman,
mm-hmm.
and between your seed and her seed.
Mm-hmm.
And he, Jesus, shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel.
All right, now.
You may be seated.
Amen.
Let me first say that the Lord is good. Amen.
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 He's more than that. That's all I know to say.
All right, now.
Yeah.
He is good.
Yes.
Shall we pray?
Mm-hmm.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank
yes.
you.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We thank you for your word, Master.
Mm-hmm.
And as your word go forth, Master, may it hearten some
yes.
heart to meet the Savior. Let them know that you are the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes.
Father God, let the meditation of my heart
yes.
be acceptable
yes.
in your sight.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm going to read one verse, and it's coming from Peter, 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 8 and 9. And it reads, be sober-minded, be watchful, for your adversary, the devil, prowls around like a roaring lion, seeking someone to devour. Resist him, firm in your faith, knowing that the same kinds of suffering are being experienced by your brothers and sisters throughout the world.
All right.
And I want to talk a little bit about how long do we have to suffer?
All right.
How long? Not long. And God's kingdom will come. His will be done
Amen.
On earth as it is in heaven.
Amen.
And let me say it's good to be in the house of prayer one more time.
Amen.
It's great to see you, my brothers and sisters. I seem to be having trouble with my glasses, so let me try it without the glasses. Will you turn also, please, your Bible to Luke chapter 16, because this is what we're going to be talking about. Luke 16. And just keep it open, will you? Because we're going to be referring to these verses 19 through 31 and find out what happens to a person when they die.
Okay.
And where they go. Is there really a hail? Is there really a lake of fire? Let us never forget Satan, because I tell you that Satan is real. Why do you say that, Sister Dottie? I say that, brothers and sisters, because as I was preparing this message, Satan and his forces were trying to block me from proclaiming this message.
All right,
now if you don't believe there's a devil, I do.
Come on now.
If you don't believe that he had demons, I do.
All right now.
What happened when I was trying to prepare for this message, my printer stopped on me 3 times while I was just typing the scriptures.
All right.
For the message. Right. Not only that, the phone calls were coming in from folks who were calling from California for Andrew that I have not talked to in 22 years.
All right now. Mm-hmm.
Don't tell me the devil ain't real.
All right now.
But we praise God for their calls, amen?
Amen.
But through it all, the Holy Spirit told me, mm-hmm. as I told my husband, I said, I've got to preach this message.
All right.
Holy Spirit said, Dottie, you will preach this message.
All right now.
Amen. You will preach chapter 16 of Luke, verses 19 through 31.
Yes. All right now.
So I don't have to tell you that Satan is real, saints of God. Because when Brother Matthew tells us in chapter 4, verses 1 and 2, that after Jesus was baptized, the Holy Spirit led him into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil 40 days and 40 nights. The devil tempted Jesus 40 days and 40 nights. A lot of people think he only tempted him 3 times. But he tempted the Lord 40 days and 40 nights. And if he does that to our Lord, this tells me that if he tried to tempt the very Son of God, then messing with me ain't no problem.
All right now.
But I thank God for his Holy Spirit.
Yes.
Because Brother John says to all believers in Christ that we belong to God.
Yes.
And greater is he that's in you than he that is in the world.
Right now.
Ain't that good news?
Yes, it is.
And I get a witness today.
Right now.
Now in the book of Genesis chapter 3 verses 15, the Lord says to the snake, I'm going to put enmity, animosity, between you and the woman, and between your seed and her seed. And he, Jesus, will bruise your head, and you, Satan, will bruise his heel.
All right.
Now I understand that the word seed in Hebrew is offspring in the Greek.
All right.
And Satan is our enemy, and the devil prowls around looking to see who he can destroy.
Right.
1 Peter 5:8 says he hates human beings.
All right, yeah.
Even though he was defeated at the cross with the death of Jesus and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, he still hates those who put their faith in Christ Jesus.
All right, yeah. Mm-hmm.
And after almost 6,000 years of waging war on God's children, we are on the straight and narrow path. The devil realizes that he only have a little time.
Mm-hmm.
How long? Not long.
All right now.
The way things are going in this world today, it is not long.
Right.
We're living in the last of the last days.
Amen.
The offspring of the woman is our Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the last Adam. According to 1 Corinthians 15:45-49, it has been said that when Satan dealt a blow to Jesus' heel, he received that. He thought that he was going to be victorious. But the Lord's death was the most powerful blow that crushed the devil's head.
Amen.
And Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice to end all sacrifices and to break the power of the enemy.
Yeah.
And now, saints of God, let's take a look about the truth of hell.
Right.
In reading the words of the Lord Jesus Christ, we know that our Lord spoke about hell in the Old and the New Testament.
Yeah.
Why do you think he spoke so much about that? A place called hell, Hades, and a place called the Lake of Fire. A place of eternal punishment. He spoke about it because he is the Word of God. And in the New Testament, in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verses 41 to 46, we found that when he physically, once again, returned back to this world, to set up his kingdom. He will judge the nations to see those who are going into the kingdom and those who will not be in the kingdom. And the scripture says, then he shall say to those on his left hand, depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. Now Hades is a place of torment and anguish, and the lake of fire is a place of eternal punishment. And they were never, never, let me repeat again, they were never, ever intended for mankind. Never. Human beings who were created in the image of God and after his likeness. But Hades and the lake of fire was ordained by the Lord as the final place of Satan and his army of fallen angels. Why? Brother Peter tells us in his second epistle, for God did not spare the angels when they sinned, but cast them into hell and committed them to chains of gloom and doom and darkness to be kept in judgment. So saints of new life, I'll say, like Brother Paul says in Romans, let God be true and every man a lie. I know that the doctrine of hell is being ridiculed by the majority of the day. If someone believes in hell, then they're called old-fashioned, or out of touch, out of step with reality. Many say that the concept of eternal hell, where unbelievers are Christ burning forever, is lucrative and deep meaning. The rational says there is no God, so there can be no hell. The religionist said there is a God, but he's a God of love, and he would never, he would not, nor could not send anyone to burn in hell. But brothers and sisters, I tell you today, I'm not concerned with folks calling me old-fashioned, because I believe there is a hell. I'm not concerned when folks say that I'm out of touch and out of step with reality, because I believe there is a lake of fire. Neither am I concerned when folks say that the lake of fire is ludicrous and demeaning. No. I'm not concerned when the rational say there is no God, so there can be no hell. I'm not concerned when the religionists say there is a God, but he's only a God of love. He would never, never send anybody to the lake of fire. But I stop by to tell you that yes, the Lord is love. And no, he would never send anyone to hell or to the lake of fire. But you will be sending yourself when you reject the work that our Lord has paid on the cross. You will be sending yourself when you reject the precious blood that he shed on the cross for the remission of all our sins. Because his word tells us that we have all sinned and come so very short of the glory of God. No. You are sending yourself to hell and the lake of fire because you don't believe in the one who's the way, the truth, and the life. The one who is the only one to the Father in heaven that's able to get you in heaven. And I say to the religionist, to the rationalist, let God be true and every man a liar. Because in the end, my brothers and sisters, it really won't matter what you think or I think about hell. Why, Dottie? Because in the book of Revelations, chapter 20, the books are open, and there's another book open, which is the book of eternal life. And all those whose names are not found in the book of life will be cast into the lake of fire. This is the second death. So let God be true and every man a liar. Jesus himself tells the outcome of this story of the rich man and the poor man, Lazarus. And I don't believe that this is a parable as some people might believe, but I believe that the story that Jesus tells about these two men in the Bible is real life story.
All right,
now. Why do you say that, Dottie? I say that because Jesus, number one, is the Alpha and the Omega.
Yes, he is.
He's the beginning and he's the end of all things. A reference to nobody but the true God himself.
Amen.
He says, I'm the first and I'm the last. I'm the beginning and I'm the end. The Alpha and Omega means that he was at the beginning of all things. And he will be at the close of all things. He has always existed. He will always exist. He is the I am that I am.
That's right, that's right.
And he says in Isaiah, my hand also have laid the foundation of the earth.
Yes.
And my right hand has spanned the heavens.
Yes.
When I call unto them,
all right now,
they stand up together.
Amen.
The Lord knows all things.
Yes, he does.
Not just things that happen in this world.
Yes.
Not just things that happen in heaven. But because of who he is, the all-knowing Son of God, means that he not only knows all things that a person can do while you're on this earth, but he also knows the things that are said and done under the earth. Can I get a witness this morning? It's been said that when somebody dies who is a believer, that their soul sleeps. But I stopped by to tell you, there is no soul sleeping.
Yes. All right now. All right now.
The Lord says when Lazarus and the rich man were alive in this world, then they died and they both were conscious. And they both were aware of what was going on in Abraham's bosom, which is now was now called paradise after Jesus rose from the dead. Both Lazarus and the rich man were very, very much aware. They were conscious of what was going on when they died. Verse 19, if you look at it with me, tells us that the rich man was clothed in purple and fine linen and lived sumptuously every day. I can imagine this rich man rejoiced daily, dressed in his fine purple garment, reflecting his degree of wealth. He saw himself as one who deserved everything that his wealth could afford him, living a luxurious style. And you notice the Lord doesn't give us the name of this wealthy man, but simply calls him a rich man.
Right.
Why? It's my understanding that in the Bible, when someone's name is not mentioned, it's to show shame.
Right.
It shows that the Lord is not pleased with this individual,
all right,
which will be confirmed shortly in verses 20 and 21.
All right, now.
We see a man who was a beggar named Lazarus, who laid at the gate of the rich man, sick and full of sores, desiring to be fed with just the crumbs which fell from the rich man's table. And the Bible said the dogs came and licked his sores. Now here's a beggar man laying at the rich man's gate, in pain, sick, and full of sores. And yet we're given his name. And what's important to know is that the name Lazarus in the Hebrew means El Azar. El being God and Azar being help. So Lazarus' name literally means the one whom God has helped. But wait a minute. Lazarus' name means the one that God has helped.
All right, now.
But you would think that the one who was extremely rich is getting all the help. Because Lazarus is the one who was poor and begging. But in verse 13 of this chapter, the Lord is telling the crowd that you cannot serve two masters. He says you can't serve two masters. You can't serve money and you can't serve the Lord.
All right now.
Money is something that is unrighteous to God. And you certainly won't be able to use it in the kingdom of God. Because the love of it is the root of all evil. So why have billions and trillions of dollars when you leave this world? You can't take it with you. Now we see Lazarus, this poor man, laying at the gate of this rich man. Why was Lazarus at the gate? Because in the Old Testament, when we read about the gate of the city, it was really a place of judgment. It was a place where God's will, the truth of God, the righteousness of God should be manifest. That means acted out. So we find Lazarus at this gate, covered with sores, in great pain, and in great need. Does this sound familiar, saints of God?
All right.
It reminds me of another man in the Old Testament who the scripture also mentioned that was covered with sores. Mm-hmm. Remember Brother Job?
All right now. Mm-hmm.
His name was also then, the one who God has helped.
Yeah. All right then.
The scripture tells us that Lazarus didn't ask to be invited for a meal at the rich man's table.
That's right.
But being so poor, sick, and hungry, he only wanted to eat just the scraps which fell from the rich man's table.
Yes.
That would have satisfied him. Mm-hmm. But this wealthy man who could have helped him did nothing for Lazarus.
Mm-hmm.
And he may have gotten some comfort by the dogs licking his sores, but the rich man did absolutely nothing.
Uh-huh.
The scripture goes on to tell us that Lazarus, the beggar man, died, and he was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom.
Uh-huh.
Remember, saints, before Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection, when a person died in faith in God, they were carried by the angels
mm-hmm.
into Abraham's bosom, which is known as paradise.
Mm-hmm.
In the book of Hebrews, chapter 1, verse 14, it says of angels, are they not all ministering spirits?
Right.
Hear me now.
Mm-hmm.
Sent out to help those who will inherit salvation?
All right now.
That's what angels are for.
All right now.
They are ministering spirits
mm-hmm.
sent out
all right now.
To help all God's children who are heirs to salvation.
All yeah. right now.
You see, saints of God, I've never seen angels.
All right.
But I sure enough have received, I've seen the results of the work they do.
Yes. All right now.
I've never seen an angel,
mm-hmm.
but I certainly have seen the results of the work they do.
Amen.
What do you mean, Dottie? I'm saying, and hear me carefully, when you are in a situation that you know without a shadow of doubt that you cannot get yourself out of.
Yes.
You know that you know.
Say it.
And then you end up being okay.
Yeah.
You know it's angels.
Alright now.
I'll give you an example. In California, my husband and I bought this little house and it had approximately 15 stairs going up this way. And I was working in San Francisco at the time where they didn't have BART at that particular time. You had to take the bus. So here I am, 8 months pregnant, going down the stairs, and somehow I tripped. 15 stairs. But when I landed, I was standing straight like this.
All right now. Yes.
You
yes.
Don't tell me.
Yes.
Don't tell me.
Yes.
The angels are not sent for those that are heirs to salvation.
Yes.
Pregnant woman walking down the steps, slipping and falling. And it's like the angels just picked me up and set me on that last step.
All right now.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
When Lazarus died, he was a man of faith.
Mm-hmm.
He was carried by the angels into Abraham's bosom. When Jesus was on the cross shedding his precious blood for our sins, he told the thief, remember, on the cross that was with him, today you shall be with me in paradise. This is where Lazarus and all the people of faith in Almighty God, when they died, and paradise is no longer there. It was moved when Jesus rose from the dead.
All right, now.
And he took all of the saints to heaven with him.
Amen.
Now, Brother Paul tells us today to be absent from the body is to be present immediately with the Lord.
All right, now.
You know, it's faster than a blink of an eye.
Yes. All right, now.
Oh, and I think that when I close my eyes, I'm in the presence of the Lord.
All right, now.
Now, the angels, are we still carried by angels? Well, I researched that and couldn't find anything on it. But then the Holy Spirit led me to where it says that the children of God, once we receive the Lord Jesus, we are sealed.
All right, now.
Sealed. By the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Until when? The day of redemption. So to me, I see, no longer do I need to be carried by angels. I feel maybe do you need to be. But you don't have to be. Because God himself is within you.
Yes.
Amen. That the Holy Spirit is God.
Yes.
And he is within you. And so as soon as you close your eyes, you're in the presence of the Lord. Ain't that good news?
All right, now.
Let's get back to this rich man that was buried. Now, he didn't have any angels to escort him to paradise. But he lifted up his eyes in hell, being in torment. Now, you notice that in hell, the rich man is very, very aware of everything around him.
Yeah.
He can see, he can hear, he can speak, he can feel. And he still have desires.
Right.
He still have needs. And he still have the ability to think and express himself, though his body is in the grave.
Yeah.
Right.
Now, I'm sure he had a big, big funeral on the day that he died. All the potentates, the rich folks with power and authority. When he died, he lifted up his eyes in hell.
Yeah.
No angel escort.
Yeah.
Why? Why didn't he have an angel escort?
Mm-hmm.
Because he didn't have faith in the Abrahamic covenant.
Amen.
This rich man knew the truth,
but
he just didn't respond to the truth.
Right.
Because it was all about him, his wants, his needs, and now he's in hell waiting for the white throne judgment of God.
Amen.
And I tell you, brothers and sisters, he's still there today.
Yes,
all right, now.
He is still there today.
Amen.
All right, now.
In Revelations chapter 20, never let anyone mislead you when you die.
All right, now.
And we all will one day.
Yes.
But if our faith is in Jesus Christ as a sacrificial lamb for sins, we go immediately in the presence of the loving God.
Amen.
Where there is love, comfort, and joy. But if you're lost, if you don't know who Jesus is, if you don't have faith in the saving work of Jesus on the cross, you will not spend 1 second in the grave, but you will immediately go into hell where the rich man is. And believe me, he's there. Because there is no soul sleeping anywhere. The rich man is fully aware and fully conscious, and he is in horrible pain.
Yes, he is.
He sees Abraham from a far distance, and he recognizes Lazarus, whose name means the one who God has helped. Now, in paradise, where there is comfort, joy, and peace, if the rich man recognizes Lazarus, this means that he could also remember how he treated him.
All right, now.
No doubt he remembered Lazarus begging at his gate. He could remember how he gave nothing to Lazarus but a hard time. And now he's in hell suffering. And he calls out to Abraham saying, Father Abraham, calls him Father.
All right, now.
Have mercy on me. He now wants mercy, but he showed no mercy toward Lazarus. And now he asked Abraham to send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in cool water so that it could cool his scorching tongue. He said, and he says in the scripture, because I'm in torment from this flame.
All
The rich man did absolutely nothing to help Lazarus while he was on this earth. But yet he is not asking for a cup of water or a glass of water, but just for Lazarus to dip his finger in cool water and cool off his tongue. Now you know he's in turn that. But while he lived on earth, he had all the water that he wanted. Now it's a different story.
Yeah.
We find his tongue is burning from the flame. What does this mean? You know, I heard a lot of people say, oh, yeah, I'm going to hell and I'm glad of it because I'm a party. But there ain't no party in hell.
Make it plain.
It's extremely hot for this rich man's tongue to be burning.
That's right.
Yeah.
It's extremely hot for this rich man to be in torment.
Yeah.
So there won't be no party.
That's right.
There won't be no air conditioning.
All right.
And there won't be no Jesus there.
That's right.
Make it plain.
It's a hot place.
Right.
Not only is it a hot place, but the Bible said it's a very dark place.
Mm-hmm.
Why is it dark, Dottie? It's dark because Jesus is the light.
All right now.
He's the one that light up your soul.
All right.
He's the one that light up your path.
Yes.
He's a lamp unto my feet and a light to my path.
All right.
That's
now.
What the Bible says.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So if you follow him, you'll never walk in darkness.
Right.
But the light of Jesus, amen, the Son of the living God,
right.
He is the source of all light to mankind.
Yeah.
Notice the rich man found himself separated from Lazarus and Abraham. And this separation of this rich man, y'all, is eternal.
Yes.
One of the most horrible things about hell would be the separation of all the good things of life.
All right.
No family. No friends, no fellowship, and most of all, just an endless separation, from the one that loved you more than anybody else could love you.
That's right.
That's why he came to this world to die for you by shedding his blood on the cross.
That's right.
Because he loves you more than anybody.
Make it plain.
His love is unconditional.
Yes,
his love is everlasting.
Yes,
my love may not be unconditional.
Right.
My love may not be everlasting. It ain't everlasting, really. But his is everlasting.
Yes.
Everlasting.
Yes.
No matter what you do, he loves you.
Yes.
And I can imagine myself, even the rich man, being in the grave because of the fact that the way he lived his life so badly, but that never stopped God from loving him. No matter where he is, God still loved him.
All right,
amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. So Abraham had to tell this rich man, you know, you remember in your lifetime, you received the good things. And now Lazarus is receiving these good things.
Right.
He's being comforted, Abraham says, and you are being tormented. This verse seemed to say that people in hell have the capacity to remember even the life that they lived on earth.
All right.
And they're forced to remember these things throughout eternity.
Right.
No doubt, they will remember every sermon that they heard and rejected.
All right now.
They will remember the words of our God when they were convicted. He was convicting their hearts, and they turned a deaf ear to the pleas of the Holy Spirit. They will remember how God manifests himself in so many ways to draw them to himself.
That's right.
They will remember that they will know, and they will know that they have nobody to blame but themselves for their situation.
Right.
You can't blame God. People always want to blame God for something.
All right now.
You cannot blame God. You have to blame yourself if this is the way that you want to live your life.
That's right.
For the devil, blame yourself when you die.
That's right.
That's who you have to blame.
That's right.
But as long as the blood is running warm in our veins, it's never too late.
Amen.
It's not too late. Why? Jesus told the crowd, if the Son of Man makes you free, you're therefore free indeed.
All right now.
Why are you free? Because the blood of Jesus Christ is more valuable than silver and gold.
Amen.
Just one drop of Jesus' blood, the Holy Son of God, can save every sinner on this earth.
That's right.
If the sinner will just trust in the Savior, because we are redeemed through and only through the precious blood of Jesus Christ on the cross, which was poured out from the Son of Man, because forgiveness depends on the shedding of blood.
Yes.
It demands and depends on the payment of penalty of sin.
Yes.
The Lord Jesus' death and the shedding of his blood is the foundation for forgiveness. And without that, there could be no forgiveness.
Yes.
His blood, his death on the cross, his resurrection.
Yes.
And Paul says that all that trust and believe in Christ Jesus should be to the praise of his glory, because we are then sealed by the Holy Spirit of promise, who is the guarantee of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession.
Yes.
So what does that mean? That means that once I have the Holy Spirit, he can't leave me.
Oh,
he'll never leave me.
Not right now.
He stuck with me.
Yeah.
He sealed me. That's what the Bible says. Put a stamp on me.
All right now.
All right? And now I'm waiting for the redemption of this body.
Yes.
When this body goes in the grave, don't mean a thing. Because I'm going to get one that's so good.
Yeah.
Right now.
It's going to be so beautiful.
Yeah.
Just being there with my Lord. Hallelujah.
All right.
The fellowship with the brothers and sisters of God. Amen.
Right.
It's just going to be beautiful.
Yeah.
It's all about, and the thing about it is, we worship God here on this earth. What's it really all about?
Yeah.
It's all about giving God the glory that he desires.
Yeah.
It's all about giving him the praise that he desires.
Yeah.
Amen?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Because God so loved you and me.
Yeah.
And I'm so grateful, Lord, that he does.
That's right.
That he gave us Jesus to pay the price for our redemption.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
To God be the glory.
Yes.
Because my soul, your soul, if you believe in Jesus.
All right.
Now, you can fool me, but you can't fool God.
That's right.
Okay?
Come on.
He knows exactly who's his and who is not.
Yes. Amen.
But all of the redeemed will be in heaven with him.
Yes.
Are you redeemed?
All right now.
I know I am,
and
I can only speak for me.
Yeah.
Amen. My soul has been redeemed.
Yes.
I have been washed in the blood of Jesus.
Right.
My soul has been redeemed, and I'm persuaded that nothing,
nothing
and nobody shall be able to separate me from the love of God.
Yes.
Death won't separate me. I'm just going to close my eyes, and I'm in the presence of the Lord Jesus. Christ died in my place. Amen.
Yes.
Hallelujah. His love lifted me.
Yes, Lord.
It did. Nothing in this life will separate me from God's love. And I'd like to make this personal.
All right now.
I can speak for me and you and speak for you.
Yes.
Nothing can separate me.
That's right.
Even through the high times won't separate
right
me.
Right now.
Through the low times won't separate
me. Right now.
All the mistakes and the bad decisions that I make won't separate God's love.
Right now.
Nothing in the supernatural realm can separate me from the love of God.
Yes.
Demonic forces cannot separate me.
Right.
Principalities of power may try to separate me.
Right.
But nothing in the course of eternity, nothing in the present,
nothing
in the past, nothing can break the bond of God's unchanging love.
Right.
No distance. No place, no height, no death, nothing will separate me from the love of God. I am forever his.
Yes.
I am forever his.
Yes.
One of these days, I'm going away.
Yes.
It won't be long. I'll be there to stay.
Yes.
The writers of the Hebrews said it's appointed to man to die once.
Yes.
After this, the judgment.
Yes.
In Abraham's bosom, Lot.
Yes.
Lazarus, whom the Lord helped, has rewarded by the Lord.
Yes.
In Abraham's bosom, there's no longer hunger for Lazarus. Yes. There's no longer pain for Lazarus.
Yes.
There's no longer sores for Lazarus.
Yes.
He is now experiencing comfort.
Yes.
Grace.
Yes.
Love.
Yes.
And joy.
Yes.
And John says that in the eternal kingdom of God,
yes,
the new Jerusalem,
right,
in heaven,
yeah,
there is no light,
right,
no candle,
yeah,
neither the light of the sun.
Yeah.
Why? Because God the Father and,
yeah,
God the Son,
right,
who is the light,
yeah,
will provide all the lights that we will ever need,
right,
when we get to glory.
Yes.
And he said that the redeemed,
yes,
of the Lord,
all right, yeah,
shall reign forever, yeah, and ever.
Yeah.
Who are the redeemed?
Yeah.
All believers, all in Christ,
right,
Jesus.
All right, yeah.
For those of you that are not in Christ,
yeah,
those of you who think you've got a lot of time, yeah, to come to
all
Jesus,
right,
how long?
How long?
Not,
right,
long?
Not long.
And God's children will be leaving here.
Mm-hmm.
I know that everybody in their family have somebody that has not given their lives to Jesus Christ.
Make it plain.
It's been said that not everybody will be preachers.
Right.
But praise God, we can all be reachers.
Yeah.
You see, saints of God, those in your family that are not saved, those husbands, reach out to them.
All right, yeah.
Those wives,
yeah,
reach out to them.
Yeah.
Those children,
yeah,
reach out to them.
Right now.
Those grandchildren, reach out to them.
Right.
Those,
right,
brothers of yours, reach out,
yeah,
to them.
Yeah.
Those sisters, those friends, tell,
yeah,
the cousins,
yeah,
all about Jesus.
Yeah.
Tell them Jesus,
right,
is the Savior, yeah, of the world,
right,
and that he's coming back again.
Yeah. Yeah.
They ought to be ready. Line up,
yes,
reach out,
reach,
touch somebody, tell them,
yes,
that Jesus,
yes,
is alive and well today.
Yes.
He's waiting,
yes,
and watching.
Yes.
He's open arms.
Yes.
All they have to do is come to him.
Yes.
Come to him.
Come
to Jesus.
Yes.
While the blood is still running warm, yes, in your veins.
Yes.
Because how long? Not long.
Not long.
How long?
Not long.
Not long.
Things are happening in this,
yes,
world.
Yes.
Folks are killing one another.
Yes.
You can't even go out to the park with people trying to kill somebody.
Right now.
How long? Not long. We're on our way,
yes,
to heaven, y'all.
Yes.
Will you be ready?
Yes.
Will you be ready?
Hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes. And my mind is made up.
All right now.
I'm ready, y'all.
Yes.
I'm ready,
yes,
to hear the soul world.
All right now.
Why? Because the world is not my home. I'm just a pilgrim,
yes,
passing through.
All right now.
I look forward. Jesus told me, store up your treasures in heaven,
yes,
where the moth can't get to them.
All right now.
I'm storing up.
All right,
my,
yes,
treasure in heaven.
Yes.
How long?
Yes.
Not long. Yes. I'm on my way, baby. I'm on my way.
Yes.
I'm heaven bound. Yes.
All right now.
Come on and go with me.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's for real.
Yes.
The doors of the church.
Doors of the church are open.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
A song.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
you want prayer. Okay. And you got this word like one of the people.
We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your soul for the love. And we pray for you. We thank you for your loving power of staying in your house. Just thank you for God ever being with us, Lord Jesus, being here for us. Thank you for blessing, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
and you are the answer, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
Lord, I know the end, Lord Jesus. We read the book.
Yes, Lord.
You are a keeper.
Yes, yes, He is. Yes, He is.
We give no room for the devil and his doubts.
Yes, that's right. Yes, Lord. That's right.
We don't take on fear because you didn't put it on.
Yes, that's right. That's right.
Just thinking that you're just and sanctifying spirit.
Yes,
you're sanctifying us, Lord Jesus. And we take this word, Lord Jesus, and we understand that there is a hell.
Yes.
There truly a hell.
Yes. Yes.
And for Lord, you prepare a place for us.
Yes, thank you.
And for the believers, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Yes.
And you're coming back one day.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Yes, you are.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah.
And you can dress the lilies of the valley.
Yes, Lord.
How much more?
Yes.
How much more?
Yes, Lord.
How much more do you love us?
Yes,
Lord.
For we truly believe and we know.
Yes, Lord.
And we're growing in our faith, Lord Jesus, every day.
Yes, Lord.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
We know we have to rely upon your faith.
Yes,
you must eliminate fear.
Yes.
The devil is busy.
Oh, yes.
He's alive and he's functioning and he's smart.
Yes, Lord.
But you're smarter.
All right now.
And we know that
in us, Jesus,
yes, Lord,
that you live.
Yes.
And you've given us the Holy Spirit.
Yes,
Lord. Yes. Lives and dwells in our souls.
Yes.
In our souls.
Yes.
We're learning.
Yes.
Lean with that upon you.
Yes.
And we're thanking you.
Thank you,
Lord. Lord Jesus, for this feeling we feel now is gone.
Yes, Lord.
We leave here today, Lord Jesus.
Yes,
it's a new day.
Yes.
And you give us another opportunity to get closer to you.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Please. And we want to thank you all. Hopefully the Lord gave you something to really ponder on. Amen.
Oh, yes.
This is very serious business.
Amen.
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 It is serious.
Yes, it is.
It is so serious.
Yes, it is.
Be ready because it won't be long.
Right.
We're going to be leaving here.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise the Lord.
Who is it? Andre Kropp said, count the weeks as months.
All
count
right.
The months as days.
Yeah.
Any day now.
Right.
We'll be going home.
All right, man.
Now may the grace of God and the love of Jesus Christ and the sweet communion of the Holy Spirit rest, rule, and abide with each and every one of you until we meet again. Let us all sing.
Amen.
God bless you.